Welcome to our commencement ceremony for 2013 Maharishi University of Management's 38th commencement. 334 students are receiving degrees today, our largest graduating class ever. Congratulations and thank you to everyone for being part of this great milestone.
As Mark Twain once said, when he was introduced with a lot of effusive praise, he said, "Sir, you'll go to heaven for your generosity." Professors and administrators, graduates, parents, family members, I want you to know I deeply appreciate the invitation to address you on this commencement day and to receive this very distinguished award. I do want you to know of my highest respect and admiration that I have for this university, for what you have done, what you've become here in Iowa, the nation and the world, and especially for what I consider to be the best holistic approach to education and wellness and life at any university anywhere on the globe. So first and foremost, congratulations to our graduates. Any counsel I can give you pales in comparison to the advice and the love and the encouragement of your parents, your grandparents, teachers, and friends here to celebrate with you today. So I thought long and hard about the best way to get my message across today, and I've chosen a method that has stood the test of time, something that has imparted wisdom to millions of people throughout the years. I think of them as 10 suggestions. Number 10, don't panic. You will find a job. My confidence is based on one thing, because you came to the right school. I have nothing, as I said, but admiration for what this university has accomplished in such a short period of time. At this university, education is also about training, focusing, freeing the mind. It's about raising consciousness. Here you have been beautifully prepared, intellectually and spiritually, for all the challenges you will face in the world out there. So you should go forth with confidence. Rule number 9, believe in yourself. You have to believe there is nothing, absolutely nothing, that you cannot accomplish through hard work and determination, plus the courage to step outside of your comfort zone. The important thing is this: to be able at any moment to sacrifice what we are for what we could become. My mother and father believed in me just as your parents believe in you. And they taught me that if you work hard and study and are responsible, you can accomplish anything in life. My parents were right. So are yours. You can accomplish anything. And today you've got the robes and the funny hats to prove it. Rule number 8, don't let the virtual world take the place of the real one. Don't let Facebook be a substitute for the real faces of your family and your friends. Don't mistake virtual avatars for the real thing. What matters are the flesh and blood people in your life. Real success is about the love you give and receive. It's about the people you touch, the lives you change. Rule number 7, don't let a few stumbles stop you dead in your tracks. The real failure would have been if I'd given up. So be prepared. You're going to suffer setbacks. You can't let that deter you. The person who never makes mistakes is the person who does nothing. So do something. Aim high, take risks, and stick your neck out. Rule number 6, 2 words, have fun. Real life is weirder than anything you've ever read about in class. Truth is indeed stranger than fiction, so enjoy it. And I remind you of the immortal words of my favorite philosopher, Ferris Bueller. He said, life goes by pretty fast. If you don't stop and look around once in a while, you could miss it. Don't miss it. Have fun, live, love, and laugh every day. Rule number 5, don't blindly follow someone else's advice. In fact, I'll go even further. Don't believe everything you think you know. That leads me to rule number 4. Express appreciation and don't hold back. If you have a professor who has been an especially great teacher or mentor here at this university, don't you dare leave today without tracking that person down and saying thank you. And say a very special thank you to your parents also. Rule number 3, keep your priorities straight. A minister who had been present at many a deathbed said, not once did a dying person ever say to me, gee, I wish I'd spent more time at the office. When all is said and done, the people in your life, your family, your faith, the friendships you form, are what give shape and substance to your life. Never, ever sacrifice that. Rule number 2, if you want your dreams to come true, don't sleep till noon. Keep challenging yourself. Keep pioneering. Get up and get out early. I know each of you have had a different experience here. Now each of you will have a different destination. But you're all leaving from the same place. As you load up the car and drive out of Fairfield, I just say this. Don't take the easy road. That easy road is a dead end. The real value of life and work isn't measured in dollars or the wealth you accumulate. It's measured in the lives you change, the people you help, the work you do to make this world a better place for all. As has often been said, we make a living by what we get, but we make a life by what we give. And that brings me at long last to rule number 1. Be a part of something larger than yourself. A big part of your experience here has been a journey inward, mastering your own mind. That journey will continue. But I also encourage you to be ambitious in your journey outward. Think of the amazing impact that Maharishi Mahesh Yogi has had on the world. One person with a vision, the energy, and leadership can inspire and move millions of people and change the world. Each of you can be that kind of a spark plug. Most of the people that I have known who have been both successful and happy are those who know themselves, who they are. This university has taught you to have the mental strength to transcend the vicissitudes of life, to know yourself. They have prepared you well for that outward journey. And you've all proven that you have the talent and the energy to accomplish big things. You know, every time I see young people like you here, and I see what you've accomplished, I don't have any fear for the future. I believe our future is in great hands. But I want you to get involved, make a difference, make change happen, be that spark plug. But always remember my rule number 6, have fun doing it. Well, so there they are. Harkin's top 10 rules to live by. Once again, my congratulations. Let me end by where I began, by quoting the great Mark Twain. Let us endeavor so to live that when it comes time to die, even the undertaker will be sorry. Good luck, best wishes, and enjoy your journey. Shouldn't take the mic again, but I'm going to teach you something. You know, my brother was deaf. I learned sign language when I was growing up. There's a lot of wonderful signs in sign language. This is one of them. It's made up of basically 3 letters. It's I, the letter L, and the letter Y. And when you form those 3, I, L, and Y, in one thing, it spells out in deaf language, I love you. Thank you.